basically what you do is you put it on behind your head, and you get a mask, and you connect to your mask, like the strings on your mask, to one of these pieces.
Crocheting to help frontline workers. That's what one 11-year-old Edmonton girl has been doing. And she's gotten her friends to help, joining a global community creating what are called ear savers. It takes Jilliane under 5 minutes to make one of these. They help hold your mask without hooking onto your ears, hoping to get them to nurses, pharmacists, or long-term care staff with thank you cards.
Because they're helping us a lot through the COVID-19, and the nurses also have longer shifts now, so the masks hurt their ears more.
If you're wearing a surgical mask for 12 hours on end, then it puts a lot of pressure on the back of your ears. It's extremely uncomfortable. You can get pressure sores from it.
Dr. Charles Larson says making masks more comfortable also means staff will be more likely to wear them properly for long shifts. He's part of a team of doctors, engineers, and designers at the U of A behind the Alberta 3D PPE. Usually, the team uses 3D printers to show kids what's wrong with their heart. Well, now they're printing reusable face shields and ear savers.
Yeah, the print of face shield takes between 2 and 4 hours.
With businesses and private citizens who own 3D printers stepping up and joining their cause. It's the people willing to help that mean the most to Dr. Larson.
No matter what happens in this crisis, that there are folks out there who are just looking for ways to help and to protect our healthcare workers.
Whether it's the thousands being printed or the 40 orders Jilliane and her friends have been stitching together from Facebook orders.
To know that my daughter and her friends are doing this for others and making an impact, even if it's small.
Also wanting to get them to the long-term care facility her great-grandmother lives at.
And all the nurses that help her, I want all of them to have one too.
Showing healthcare workers they are appreciated. In Edmonton, Carly Robinson, City News.